dark skies and stormy weather. That's alright, as long as it's you with me.
I'm Peggy Kelly, and I get the privilege of hosting the Open Range Concerts thanks to Faith United Church. So just great to have you here. And I'm so excited this year we're able to add a few things. First of all, we have refreshments. So we'll take a little break between the opening set and our featured artists. So help yourself. There's a little donation basket. And so the other thing we've been able to add this year is having some of our great local talent do an opening set. So tonight we have our very favorite Mother Pluckers. Yeah! So we have Jen and Rayanne and Carrie and Darcy, and they're going to play for you for about a half hour, and then we'll take a little break. And like I said, there's some refreshments back there, and our featured artist, Two Crows for Comfort, are from Canada, so I had to make Canadian date bars as well.
Yeah.
It just had to be.
Yeah.
So. But just relax, have a good time. You know, we're all grown-ups. If you need to get up and move around, feel free. Just have fun, and that's what it's about, right? Ladies,
woo.
This is yours.
Thank you. Thank you, thank you.
Yeah, thanks to Peggy for organizing these and bringing more interesting artists.
Come to all of them.
She they've been
incredible
amazing.
Musicians.
Too. Yeah, they really have. So this is, we'll run through this and see how we sound, right?
Yeah.
All right.
First one's over.
Miles, 100 miles, 100 miles, 100 miles. home, away from home. Lord, I'm 500 miles away from home.
Not a shirt on my back, not a pendant to my name. Lord, I can't go back home. This away.
I know here too. Like I've been like, oh, they're smiling. Oh, they like us. They're our friends. They're like, that's awesome.
Maybe they went to dinner and had a few drinks.
I hope so. They did. Here, my sisters. What are we doing?
Little Mississippi John Hurt.
Ooh. Gotta put myself capable one.
Well, folksy bluesy.
Folksy bluesy. That's what we do. Right. You got your right. Ooh, the bongos are coming out, Jen. Jen's ready to go crazy. Yeah, come on. You just beat those bad boys up. All right. You ready?
Soft and low. When I'm broken, I got
excited about the harmonica?
I love the harmonica. I always am a fan of the harmonica. So.
We just added this on Monday.
Yeah, oh, this is like a last minute. Slide it in there.
Two notes. She's like, you just play it the whole song. I'm like, well, not if it's off key. She's like, it doesn't matter.
It doesn't matter. Keep playing. I don't care. They'll like it. Everybody will like it.
blues. Strap yourself to the tree with roots. Well, you ain't going nowhere. Ooh-wee, ride me high. Tomorrow's the day that my bride's gonna come. Oh, 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 we gonna fly down in the easy chair. Bride's gonna come. Oh, 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 we gonna fly down in the easy chair. Louie, ride me high. Tomorrow's the day that my bride's gonna come. Oh, 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 we gonna fly down in the easy chair. Down in the easy chair.
Got what they need?
I think so. Is this right? This, yeah, this must be right. We'll go with it. We're gonna just go with it.
That's the theme of the day.
Buckets of rain, buckets of tears. Got all them buckets coming out my ears. Oh, buckets of movies in my hands. You got all the love. Pretty people disappear like smoke. Oh, friends with a ride.
are going to do a Kermit the Frog.
Yay!
You're setting the pace on this. We change the pace of this all the time. Sometimes we do it faster, sometimes slower.
Sing along.
Yeah, sing along. Rainbow Connection. We know this, right?
Why are there so many songs about rainbows? And what's on the other side? Rainbows are visions, but only illusions. Rainbows have nothing to hide. So we've been told, and some choose to believe it, but I know they're wrong. Wait and see. Someday we'll find it, the rainbow connection, the lovers, that every wish would be heard and answered when wished on a morning star. Somebody thought of that, and someone believed it, and look what it's done so far. What's so amazing and keeps us stargazing, and what do we think we might see? Someday we'll find it, the rainbow connection, the lovers, the dreamers, and me. All of us under its spell, we know that it's probably magic. Have you been half asleep, and have you heard voices? I've heard them calling my name. Young sailor, the voice might be one and the same. I've heard it too many times to ignore it. It's something that I'm supposed to be. Someday we'll find it, the rainbow connection, the lovers, the dreamers, and me.
Before a little break and get some snacks, and then Two Crows for comfort. We can hardly wait. So, yay!
Oh, here, let's go.
All right, so, Darcy.
Yeah.
Darcy, it's all you, baby.
We're just, there we go.
Are you stuck?
We got one.
All right, everybody's good?
All right. A little Annabelle.
Little Annabelle.
These 20 acres and a one genie mule from the Alabama Trust, half of the cotton and a third of the corn. You get a handful of dust
Mother Pluckers. Yeah. Thank you, ladies. That was awesome. I do want to tell you all that it's your support of this series that has allowed us to add this opening set and be able to involve our local musicians. So thank you. You're the ones who are letting us do this. So I'm very grateful. So now I'm ready. We're ready for the second half, our featured act. We have Aaron and Corey, Two Crows for Comfort from Canada. This is our first truly international open range concerts up north, so I'm excited about that. Woo! Yeah. And I know Canada's just right there, but they're not from just right there. They had to drive to get here. And they're not going to see Canadian soil again for about 8 months. So we're the kickoff on their most of 2024. So we're special. So I'm thrilled that they reached out to me and I listened to a little bit of their music. I'm like, oh, yes. So I'm thrilled to be able to introduce Aaron and Corey to Craig for Comfort to you. And I do need to be sure and thank the Arrowhead Regional Arts Council for making the Open Range Concerts feature artists possible. It is through the legacy funding that is part of the Minnesota. It's tax dollars that are for arts and culture and history. And I'm the Arrowhead Regional Arts Council, we're in that area, so I'm able to write grants and have been fortunate enough to be able to receive funding to do these fun things and bring people up. And we're not, you know, really on anybody's beaten path. So it takes some resources to get people to come up here. So I want to thank the voters of Minnesota. And I do want to just point out, you know, don't ever take that for granted because it has to continually be approved. And I lived in another state for a long time, for many decades, where there wasn't anything like this. Minnesota is unique in having this kind of funding. And I lived in a state where a governor came in and said, we don't need any arts in this state. And what little bit of funding there was took that away. So appreciate what we have, make sure to support it, and then participate in the great things that happen here. There are several things that happen in the falls because of the Arrowhead Regional Arts Council, so thank you to them. So without ado, let me introduce to you Two Crows for Comfort. Woo-hoo!
All right, we'll warm up with this little song. We're going to play a bunch of songs we wrote, and maybe we'll sneak in some cover songs. We're not sure yet. We kind of have a plan, but we never really have much of a plan. We just sort of wing it, but wing it. Aaron's laughing at the pun. We put up this little sound system just so the acoustics in here are ridiculously good, so if we're too loud, just tell us that we're too loud, because we almost don't even need it, but we'll see. So we'll do this one. This is a song I wrote. We're from Manitoba, and I grew up in a town called Stony Mountain, and I grew up right down the street from federal prison. And that was my neighbor. My school shared a fence line. That's a true story. We shared a fence. And it's a maximum security prison. And yeah, I grew up right down from there, which was an interesting upbringing. And so we wrote a song about it, and we'll ease into the night with a song about prison.
I've been looking backwards for most of my life. Living faster, I love it. The light now, the grass is greener. If you let it go, you're so out of tone. I've been around the block a time or two. You know I started late. Now I lost my shoe, and so I follow the wind till it blows me right back to you.
Took our mixer and we turned the sound all the way down and we just played unplugged for the last set. We haven't been invited back for some reason. All right, good. If you're happy, we're happy. That's good. This is a song I wrote about my dad, and it's a bit of a Canadian cliche, but a Canadian kid, I played hockey all my life. And since I was 4 years old, I started playing hockey when I was 4 years old. And I played up right through high school until I was about 18. And my dad was my coach when I was a kid, just playing local club hockey in Stony Mountain. And he would drive me to all the games. Him and my mom, they would come to all the games, all the practices. And then even when I got older and I started playing a little bit higher level and was driving myself to the games or getting on a bus, they would still show up at all the games. And they, my dad would get home at, we'd drive in the middle of nowhere, so he'd be home at 2 o'clock in the morning or 3 o'clock in the morning, and then he'd get up at 5 o'clock and go to work the next day. And he did that for so many years, and I never really thanked him for it, or I probably didn't really appreciate it as a kid. And I know in hindsight that how insane that must be to do that. And so I was kind of thinking about that when I was writing this song and wondering how he stayed sane in all those years. And how invincible he was, and I think we all kind of look at our dads as being this almighty, invincible being. And now I'm kind of watching my dad slow down, and it's kind of weird to watch your parents age, and for me specifically, my dad, watching my dad age is really a really weird thing. So that's what this song is about. It's a song about my dad getting older, and it's called Older Still.
Shaking and me stays growing older still.
amazing. Bet you after the first song, you're like, oh, this is going to be a really cheery band. We open with that, and then we just slide downhill. No, I'm just kidding. We won't do that. Actually, to be totally honest, usually it's kind of nice when we do these little intimate shows, and it's a really rainy night. It's an excuse for us to whip out all our most depressing material. If you want it, we can do it, but I have a feeling you won't. So we won't. Time we wrote about traveling, we travel a lot. Like Peggy mentioned, this is our first show of Boda. We have a year-long visa. We have to get a visa to come down here and play, and we have a year-long visa, so we're gonna be on the road for about 8 months, and before we go back home, 7 or 8 months, and then we're gonna go home, and then we're gonna go back into California, home, over to Alaska, home. So we're gonna be kind of on the road for about a year. So this is the first show of the whole thing, which is crazy. Oh, cool. Thank you for spending with us. And so this is a song about traveling and doing what we do, and we love to travel. We live in a little 18-foot camper that we travel in and with our dog. And so this is a song called Into the Wild. Some new stuff. I know it's all new to you guys, but a bunch of new stuff to us. So this is one of those new songs, and it's about being bad at relationships. I'm really good at being bad at relationships. Join the two. Yes, this is for you.
Stay out too late. Streetlights flood the summer sky. I'm in no hurry to get home. Dark all night long, without even speaking to could read my mind all along. Promise the world that we'd make it, with hearts on your name, but we break it, we break.
No more eye in a bottle of wine. Shadow stands by the firelight.
Thank you very much. Another song about Aaron. I've recently started writing songs about Aaron. Yeah. Actually, this is an old one. This is an old one. I wrote this when I used to date Aaron's best friend. It's a true story. That's not a joke. I got to know Aaron a little bit through...
No overlap.
Aaron likes to clarify that there was no infidelity. But I did used to date her best friend, and I got to know Aaron a little bit through that, and Aaron kind of bounced overseas back and forth. She was lived in Italy and Ireland, doing jobs there back and forth for a couple years, and when my relationship with that other person fizzled out, I started kind of chatting with Aaron a little bit more on Facebook, and she would come back and forth, and when she would come home, she would work at the same place that I worked at. Which was a pawn shop. And that's the romantic part. And so we got to know each other really well, and we started hanging out. And Aaron had a return trip booked back to Italy, and but she basically never went back. We went back and visited a few years later, but she never went back to stay. She kind of stuck around with me. Which is pretty cool. We've been together for about 8 or 9 years. We're not really sure. We don't really count, but probably feels like a lifetime locked up in a camper with me. But we've been together for about 8 or 9 years, and anyways, I wrote the song a little bit of how our relationship started, and it was all based on teasing. I would just rag on Aaron relentlessly until eventually she decided she liked me too. So it's a song about Aaron. It's a love song. It's called Misery.
Not as close as we used to be. Across the ocean, lost at sea. Do you miss the misery? Do you miss the misery?
Experience touring. We tour a lot, and This was our first experience of it was a real roller coaster, and then it has been ever since. So we were playing a bunch of shows that started off really good on the tour, and usually it's a bad sign. Like, the show is good, so it's a bad sign. That means tomorrow's going to suck. But that's kind of how our first tour went. We were shocked by the fact that people actually wanted to come out and see us, and it wasn't just our friends and family in our little town. And we were making our way home, and we were stopping as a Thursday night downtown. You might have heard of it because you're close enough to Canada that you've heard of Canada. The further south we get, the less likely anyone has heard of it, especially our province. But we were playing in a city called Regina, Saskatchewan. I don't know if you're familiar with Regina. Okay. Nice, see? You're close to the border, you get it. So that's where we were playing, and we were expecting a really, really good show because our kind of heads were blown up a little bit from all the good shows we were having. And we started playing, and sort of this realization washed over us that not a soul in the bar could care less that we're here. And we had 3 hours to fill. And it was a long, miserable night, and that was our first experience with that, and it happens all the time, unfortunately, now, but we're used to it now. We just have fun with it, and so we got a song out of it, at least, and it's called To Regina With Love. We were there, and it was awful. We were in our little camper. We got caught in the California rainstorms and the snowstorms that hit Portland and the Oregon coast. We were camping in, I don't know what the conversion is in Fahrenheit, but it was about minus 14 Celsius one night. And we were caught camping in that. We got shut down on the Pacific Coast Highway for a bit. We got stuck there for about 6 hours, just us and about five other people. And that was kind of what the two-week trip was like. It was absolutely miserable, but it was also super, super fun and rewarding because we got through it. And our friends had an absolute blast, and we were, it was a horrible time to happen. I'm trying to use my words lightly, not use too many bad things. It was a great trip nonetheless. We hung out in parking lots, drank cardboard box wine, and that was it for 2 weeks, so we got a song of that too. It was like this.
Drive the western coast together, perfect skies, and stormy weather, that's alright, as long as it's you with me. Ocean side or a parking lot, playing games we long forgot, that's alright, we're out here making memories. Can't tell me how to move along. Can't tell me how.
Best cover song was already done tonight. So.
Actually,
Ring of Fire. That's a good. That was a great start. But then we're like, shoot. We needed that in case we needed to end on something good. No.
It was great.
And then you guys did Five Hundred Miles, and we're like, oh, dang it. That's also one. That's also one we could have done. Shoot. We like trying to do one cover song just for fun, just to test ourselves. I don't know the words to this, but see what happens.
Yeah.
my parents' wedding song. Talk about traveling with our dog. We love dogs very, very much. We adopted a boxer from a rescue in Winnipeg, and he was a year and a half when we got him. And basically, what we were told from the family was that they were getting divorced, my mom and dad, and they had the dog, and they didn't want him anymore, so they put him up for adoption. And so we took him home, and we kind of joke now that we realize why they gave him up. I don't know if anybody's had a boxer or knows a boxer. They're absolutely psychotic.
He was crazy.
He was nuts, and he had crazy separation anxiety, and which kind of makes sense. He just being given away, the dogs get traumatized really easily, and he wouldn't even come in the house the first day. He was just terrified, shaking on our back deck, but eventually he warmed up to us. But he still had that anxiety every time we would leave. He would just destroy everything we owned. We had an old house that was built in the 30s, and it was all the original doors and hardwood floors and baseboards and you name it. And he just shredded everything we had. And so we had to do a complete reno before we sold the place. So he cost us a lot of money. But he was adorable, and we were never mad at him because he was so adorable. And Christmas a couple years ago, We were petting him and rubbing his head and his neck, and all of a sudden we felt a big lump on his throat. And so we took him in to get some tests done, and it took a little while for the vet to get back to us, and once they figured it out, they told us he had lymphoma. It's really common in boxers, cancer. And he was at stage 4 by the time we figured it out. There were no signs of it, because boxers, they're so rangy that you never know that they're slowing down until it's super, super late. And he's not wrong, yeah. So we got that figured out, and we wanted to try chemotherapy for him and try to give him a fighting chance at least. We knew he wouldn't have a long life, but we wanted to see if we could give him at least a little quality left. And we were doing some the first few treatments went really, really well, and he was responding really well. And then we noticed he was kind of starting to slow down again and get sluggish after the first few weeks. And we took him in for another routine treatment, and the vet called us, and they told us we should come in because he's not going to come home. And so we went and spent our last night with him, and he passed away just before his fourth birthday. He was still a baby when we got home. And we travel with we call him his brother. They're not from the same litter, but from the same rescue. And Elliot is our dog that travels with us now. And they were brothers, and so we're really happy to be traveling with our buddy. It was supposed to be two, but it's just one. And but his name was Frankie, and we called him Frankenstein because he was an absolute monster. So we call this song Frankenstein's Waltz. We have the CDs as well, but there's Frankenstein's Waltz is on there, and we recorded that song before Frankie passed away, and he's howling at the end of the song because he loves the harmonica. He would go bonkers for the harmonica, so we record him at the end of that. So you'll hear that. Yeah, yeah. Anyways, we'll do a couple more. Is that okay? Two more. Yeah. Okay, two. This is a song we wrote. I'm not sure. We were debating if we should do this song or not. But it's a cool story. It's a really cool story.
It's historical.
It's a piece of American history. We wrote this after we visited Salem, Massachusetts the first time. So you're probably familiar with the history. And we were fascinated by everything that went down. And we were aware of everything that happened. But there was one guy who was accused of being a witch. And his punishment that was different than everybody else was to be pressed to death, which was... Most people, I don't think, knew that. We didn't know that. A lot of people we talked to didn't know that. But that was the punishment for one person. And his name was Giles Corey. And he wouldn't admit to being a witch. And that's how he died. And basically, they just took these giant stones and laid them on his chest until the stones did their job and the weight was too much. And so we thought that was just a fascinating story and wanted to write a song about it. So This is a song we usually close on, but it's kind of dark to close on. So we'll do one more after that that's a little happier. We'll pretend like the next song is the encore or something. But yeah, it's called The Ballad of Drought Corey. Dip back into Canada, actually, for we got to go into Montreal, Ottawa area, and then we go back down to the States for the rest of it. But we'll be far from home. Yeah, this is a really, really nice start. So thanks for hanging out, and of course, the Mother Pluckers for kicking things off and getting everybody warmed up. We'll take it. If anybody can help push that fame button, we'll take it. We're just having a blast doing whatever happens in our lives. It's all good. We just get to travel and do this every night, which is super, super cool. So. But I mean, if you get $1 million checks every once in a while, that'd be cool too. And of course, Peggy for booking us and answering our cold call. This is an absolute fact that maybe about 10% of people actually answer us when we send an email, and that's probably being generous. So we send thousands.
And that's not yeses.
That's not yeses either. That's just answering us, which is also a lot of no's. And so we send thousands and thousands of emails, essentially cold calls to people with no idea who we are, and we just cross our fingers and hope they're interested in having us out or have time in the schedule. And Peggy is one of the very, very few that actually said yes. So you are on. You have no idea how much we appreciate it. Seriously. I'm not just saying that to say it. We do appreciate it so much. How do Aaron does a lot of digging through the dark web. We have a lot of resources to find places to play.
Are you still selling CDs?
We are selling CDs, yeah. We have some CDs and vinyl records, tote bags, shirts. Do we have the posters? We had posters. Nobody wants posters anyway. But we have posters in our camper like 20 minutes away. Not that that's helpful to any of you. But we forgot them in the camper. But we do have CDs and all that stuff. And we have a bunch of stickers that are free if you like free stuff. Please take stickers because we printed 50,000 of them and we need to get rid of them. and I think that's it. Thank you guys. Aaron's telling me I have to tell everybody about an email list because we were always told, people ask us, why don't you have an email list going? We use Instagram and Facebook and all that stuff, but it kind of sucks. Nobody really sees, the algorithms don't make sense and nobody really sees what we do. So we're trying to promote our email list in case you are interested in where we might be going or when we might come back. Or we have a bunch of new music coming out in case you can find it online. We got a little email list sign up there too if you're interested. And I think that's it. You raised your hand for a question.
I want to know the band, your name.
Our name?
Oh,
see, we're so bad. Aaron's feeding me lines because we don't promote ourselves at all. We're Two Crows for Comfort.
Yeah.
We are, that's who we are.
And why?
Well, it's a terrible story. We have so many good stories except the one about ourselves. But the truth is, Aaron and I started playing. We were just kind of show up at open mics. I was playing in a band. Remember that ex-girlfriend I mentioned earlier?
Yeah.
So I played in a band with her and our bass player, who also had a crush on her for a minute, and then also had a crush on Aaron. And then that all fizzled out. A little bit Fleetwood Mac-y of us. Ironically, his last name is Mac. That's a true story. we just show up and play open mic. That band fizzled out. And then Aaron and I just wanted to play music, and I had been playing music since high school in bands, and I just wanted to keep playing music. I had some songs that I'd written that we wanted to try, and so we just started showing up at open mics, and then everyone's like, from the open mics, somebody's like, oh, come play here, come play my open mic, or come play at this, I put music at a bar, so we started learning songs and writing more songs, and we kind of jokingly just call ourselves a different name when we would show up at a venue. Nobody knew who we were because we were just Corey and friends or Aaron and friends, or our bass player's name was the name of our band for a second or whatever. So we didn't have a name, so we were like, man, we should probably pick a name so people actually know how to find us. And so I just had a book of lines that I wanted to put in a song, just one-liners really. And one of them was something along the lines of Two Crows for Comfort. And we're like, yeah, I guess that works. We're a duo. It works. It's cheesy. People seem to remember it, whether you hate it or love it. People remember it, so I guess it's good. I don't know. So that's a terrible, long, boring story.
And behind the scenes.
But now you know. Now you know. Now I got to bore you for another 4 minutes before you go home. There do Q&A if anybody has any more questions. I don't know what you do.
Where are you from in Manitoba?
Sorry?
Where are you from in Manitoba?
So she's from Stonewall, I'm from Stony Mountain. Just north of Winnipeg, 20 minutes north of Winnipeg. That's it? Okay, we'll just shut up and sing. Like the chicks say, shut up and sing. Thank you guys for hanging out with us. This is a song that we wrote right when we got home from our last big stint in the States, and we were feeling really, really inspired and really grateful for everybody that took care of us and put us up and said yes to us and showed up at our shows, and we were just blown away at the end of it. There's obviously shows that suck, but for the most part it's like this, where it's just a room full of awesome people who for some reason decided to come spend the night with us, and we were feeling really, really special. So we wrote a song about that. It's kind of just a thank you to, like I said, to everybody who who supports us and continues to do so while we're on the road and takes care of us and makes our families really happy that we're taken care of while we're out and about. So that's what this song is. It's called A Few More Miles. And yeah, we're too close for comfort, and this will be our last song. So thank you guys so much.
Looking backwards for most of my life.